Before you begin, remove the service cover, wireless LAN module, solid-state drive or wireless WAN module, hard disk drive cover, hard disk drive assembly, keyboard, top cover, USB board, battery, and fan. Removal. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the display panel cable ZIF connector and disconnect the display panel cable from the system board. Disconnect the power connector cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the hard disk drive ZIF connector and disconnect the hard disk drive adapter cable from the system board. Remove the 3 4-millimeter T9 Torx head screws identified with a triangle that secure the system board to the base enclosure. Remove the USB bracket from the system board. Lift the left edge of the system board off of the alignment pins and slide the external connectors out from the cutouts in the base enclosure. Caution! Do not lift the system board by the heatsink. To avoid any damage to the system board, handle it as close to the center as possible. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install onto the new system board. Memory boards, heat sink, real-time clock, RTC battery, solid-state drive, if installed. Reverse this procedure to install the system board. Important: after a system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.